Guys, how's it going? It's Jeremy here with Deciples Garage, Deciples Corner, Scottsdale Home Renovation, Scottsdale Home Remodeling, Scottsdale Homes LLC. I got a lot of stuff going on lately. Missed you guys. I get back on every now and again, and I see the views, and I see the comments and stuff, and I just feel really bad about not getting something up. So here is your update. Here's the breakdown of what's been going on around here lately, okay? The reason there really hasn't been any videos lately is for the simple fact of Barter Kings. If you guys seen the show, you know what I'm talking about. It's kind of dumb in the sense that, you know, it's kind of unbelievable to the point where, you know, it just looks scripted. The show just appears to be scripted because the deals that these guys make, it just doesn't seem like they could possibly happen or people couldn't be that, you know, desperate. But for those of you who hadn't seen the movie, it's on A&E, and it basically just goes back to the old school concept of bartering, which I think that we're slowly working our way back to. I think it's going to be the currency, but the idea of bartering, you know, just trading for something that you need, basically got escalated into trading for something worth more than what you're trading for, and slowly starting a trade string to trade up to something worth more than what you started with. Makes sense. I mean, there are people out there that have stuff laying around that they don't necessarily want, they really don't want anymore, and it might be worth more than what you're bringing to the table to trade them, but they can use what you're trying to trade them versus what they have sitting around. So a lot of times they'll do it, and that's kind of what I got into, and that's kind of how I got really sidetracked from the bodywork and stuff. But it's nice background to have when you're trading for stuff, because a lot of times people want to trade bikes or four-wheelers or, you know, different kinds of things that you can do work to and paint and make it look way better and be able to trade it up for something worth a lot more than what you would if it wasn't cleaned up and whatnot. So just to recap, I'm going to try to keep this as short as possible. I know it's already probably getting kind of long, but I mean, I want to keep this under 30 minutes because I don't want to have to sit around for 2 hours waiting for it to upload because my internet's slow. So to recap here, I even wrote this stuff down so that I wouldn't forget, and then I lost the notebook. Commercial break. Here it is. Okay. So what I did here, and excuse the messes, my whole property is a complete disaster. I mean, we had garage sales set up, benches and everything. I just cleaned off the bench and got it put away and just got everything stacked. But all that stuff was down here on a table. I mean, we had shit everywhere. I still got stuff laying around that we're taking pictures of and trying to sell. Bunch of insulation from the project we're doing downstairs. I'll get to that. I have so many things to tell you guys. Okay, so I had the sisters over here set up the compressors. The one I got for $50 and the one I got for free. The one I got for free had a minor problem with it. It was like $1 to fix. You know, it had a little O-ring. Those little copper crush rings actually were bad on it, on the line going to the tank. So it was an easy fix. Anyways, I got that at the end of the road off of Craigslist. Okay, so I started with the compressor, and I traded to a crossbow. Okay, it was a pretty cool little crossbow, and it was worth about $150. It was worth about $160, $70, $80 retail. I had seen it for. It was discontinued, but you know, it was a nice little starter crossbow. It wasn't nothing. It wasn't that nice. It wasn't a big nice, you know, $200-$300 crossbow. It was decent though. It was fun. So the guy came here. Actually, had a table right there, and he parked his car down there. Talked to me about getting it painted. He wanted to paint his car, and he wanted a bigger compressor. He had seen Barter Kings before, you know, so I wasn't pulling anything with him. I didn't really have to pull anything with him. He wanted the compressor. He didn't want his crossbow. It was easy trade. So it was like brand new condition. Came with arrows and a brand new case. So it was a sweet deal. So I made the trade. I held on to it as soon as he left the driveway, I took pictures of it and posted it for trade. He had not put it on Craigslist for trade. He had mentioned it or something, and I don't think he had pictures, and if he did, they were really bad pictures and you couldn't even hardly see it. So I posted really good pictures of it up there, put it up for trade, blah, blah, blah. Actually, I got a few responses, but the best way to do it was I found a guy that had a boat. He was looking to trade his boat, and he said he's interested in anything, mostly hunting items, this and that. I told him I have a crossbow. I told him what it was. He's kind of like, you know, can you add something else to the deal? You know, this is a, the boat was just running, and I think it's got a bad lower unit, he said. He had it out on opener this year, and which at the time was about 3 months prior to the trade. I said, you know, I can throw in a trail cam. I had a really cheap trail cam I bought like 5 years ago for $70, a Wild View trail cam. It's the cameras you put in the woods, take, you know, it takes pictures of deer for you, you know, or whatever's moving around. So I said I could throw in trail cam and maybe some of my gear, you know, some of my bow hunting gear, like a jacket and stuff. You know, I had all the cheapest stuff from Walmart, you know, sitting in a bin downstairs. So I said, you know what, whatever, just bring what you got and meet me out there. It's at my buddy's house. So I get there and I find out that it's at his buddy's house. He doesn't have a truck anymore. Buddy wants it out of his yard. So it was a pretty much a, it was also an easy trade. You know, I busted out the crossbow. I said, here it is, pretty cool and stuff. And whatnot, and checked out the boat a little bit, and the boat had a $200 or over a $200 marine battery sitting in it. It had brand new wheels and tires on the trailer, brand new lights, brand new crank, all this brand new stuff on it already. I'll give you the before picture here. So I brought the boat home, and here is its current condition right now. I put the camo job on it. I stenciled it out and painted it all myself. It does have a 50 horse Merc on it, and the lower unit is not bad. I pulled the lower unit on it and put a vice grips on it, and it spun around just fine. The reason he couldn't get it started is because it was stuck in reverse. And he thought the reason it was stuck in reverse was because the motor was locked up or something somehow, when really it was just the Merc controller had a bad, some kind of weird ball bouncing around in the controller here, and was sticking the handle back in reverse and wouldn't let it come up to neutral to be able to start. So once I took that apart and stuff, it was all good to go. I ripped the carpet out already, putting this new brown carpet in it, and then these seats here I bought. So I got some seats to put in here. I got to lay the brown carpet down. I was gonna put a pedestal here, one there, one back here. It's a potato guy. And then up here, I got this burlap blind material to throw on the canopy, if you guys seen the picture of the canopy. And these are the covers for these seats here. So I just gotta wrap those. I went to Harbor Freight and I bought some tarp, some camo tarp material. And I was just gonna wrap it around this, staple it on, and bolt everything back on it, and she's pretty much good to go. There's a couple holes in the floor. I'm just dropping a sheet of plywood in here. Done deal. And then I gotta bolt everything back on. I pulled all the snaps off. There's little holes for all the snaps all the way around these things. I gotta put those all back on and clean my tape off. It's been on there for about 3 weeks now probably. So yeah. And then as far as the trailer goes, I just Permatexed it. Permatex is awesome, you guys. If you ever want to spray on some undercoating that's similar to the 3M in the can, it's the same exact stuff, only it's about $5 instead of $8 at O'Reilly's or wherever. So, like I said, brand new wheels. He had brand new tires on there. The frame was all white, you know. If you see here, I'll show you the picture again. So I went ahead and painted that. I ran out of Permatex up here, so I just finished it off with some black spray paint. But it's got a brand new crank, like I said. He bought all this stuff at the same time. So he's got a newer jack, crank. Let me get that mounted back on there now that it's done being painted. And that's it. Oh, and all the lights are new on the trailer. So, I mean, there's a good... I mean, the trailer's got to be worth $300 by itself. That's where I had it on for the garage sale. I had $1,100 on it. But you know, it's got a gas tank, it's got everything I need, and I just got to get it running good, and I got to do it fast because I got to get rid of this thing. I would really like to take it out a few times. But yeah, so that's the boat situation. I'm trying to once I get the carpet in, I'm thinking get the carpet in, get the canopy up, sell it like a duck boat, even though obviously it's too deep of a hole for a duck boat. I got some more painting touch-ups to do. I was gonna go a little further under the belly, and on the dash on the inside, it's really weird looking. I was gonna put a few more cattails and stuff on there, but and then think about doing something with the boat motor, as far as maybe just spraying it black again just to make it look nicer. But yeah, that's that. I was hoping to get, you know, $1,600 for it. I mean, the little John boat fishing boats around here can go for that much with 9-horse Mercs on them, you know, little 9-horse Johnsons and stuff. So I don't see why I wouldn't be able to drop this fast for $1,500, you know. So I turned I turned a free compressor into probably a $1,500 boat. Once I cash out on that, I'll let you guys know. Okay? Cool. So that's that one. That was my first trade string. It's not quite complete yet. I mean, I do have a boat. If I get it fixed, I could just keep the damn boat, you know? And then I have a boat, you know, for me and the family to go out, because we really don't have any other toys, you know? But it's end of the season. It's starting to get cold up here in Minnesota. It was in the mid-50s the other day. And then it was 80-something the day before that, so it's starting to get chilly. Okay, the second trade, I traded our TV. I bought a TV on Black Friday last year, or 2 years ago. 2 years ago now. It's a two-year-old TV. It was a 47-inch Apex, you know, older, or off-brand, you know. It was an off-brand, whatever, LCD, 60 hertz. I think it cost me about $450 on Black Friday 2 years ago. Right now, you can go and spend $450 and get a 47-inch LCD, 60-hertz LCD, in 1080p, like a Sansui, or like a more known name at least, you know, still a kind of an off-brand name, but I mean, you can get them for $450, $470 now. So the TV, if I tried selling on Craigslist, I priced it at about maybe $300. It'd be worth maybe $350 tops. So I traded my TV to a guy for that trailer that you just seen. It's this car trailer. He didn't really need it, I guess. So it was full of shingles too at the time. So I had to unload all the shingles off of it and whatnot. So homemade trailer, as you can see, just cobbled the front of it and stuff, all cobbled up. But if you go underneath and you look at how they did this, see what I'm saying? They got this big brace that, you know, that goes all the way through and under the tunnel into the inside. It's just, they just welded the shit out of this thing too. Heavy as hell. It takes almost two guys to lift the tongue up. It's all bar grade on the sides. I mean, it was used for heavy machinery, bobcats, that kind of thing. The fenders on it were terrible. I haven't got the new ones on yet, but I was able to get the old ones chopped off. Still got some brackets to chop off here and get that new fender welded on there. The tires aren't the greatest, and it just looks terrible. Needs black paint and whatnot, so. But that's what it should look like as far as the fender goes once I'm done, so that looks a lot better. Got those fenders for about $35 a piece at Fleet Farm. And then, you know, the lights and everything. That's dual axle, mobile home axles. So it's completely homemade. It has a little bit of a dovetail to it. The only thing that sucked with this thing is it didn't have the bar grade on this side. As you can see, it's just flat metal. It doesn't match the bar grade that runs up and down this side. And that one piece of bar grade is like over $120 just for a piece of bar grade to go right here. Of the same grade of this stuff. Because that stuff's, it's just heavy as hell. So what I'm doing is ripping this one off and I'm putting this mesh on here to cover up the whole thing. I'm going to put some flat metal here, leftover metal from the fenders, and then putting this that stuff back on and painting the whole thing black. So that'll be that. I'm seeing these trailers go for, even the homemade ones, go for around, the cheapest homemade one I seen I think was like $1,300, but it wasn't nearly as heavy duty as this thing is. I mean, I can mark it as a car hauler, but I can also mark it as a heavy machinery hauler, because this thing, it'll haul tons and tons of weight. I think most of the trailers are rated at 7,000 or 6,000 pounds, the car hauler trailers that I'm seeing. And I think this one is on the mobile home axles. If you guys can correct me, that'd be great, or tell me where I can find out what it's rated at. But I was told they're about 7,000 pounds per axle, so I think this will be about a 14,000 pound trailer then. So, I don't know. Oh, it says gross vehicle weight's only 45. There's Class C, 4,500 pounds gross vehicle weight. So maybe that's what I go off of. That can't be right. 4,500 pounds. It should be licensed for heavier than that. I don't know. Because I was told that the tandem axle car hauler trailers that you can buy for like brand new for 1,600, the cheapy ones, are like 7,000 pounds rated. They're rated for a car or maybe a truck or whatever. And this thing is rock solid, dude. It weighs a ton. Fully sheeted. It could use some bigger leaf springs under it. Maybe that's why it's only rated at 45. I don't know. Or maybe that's just they didn't want to pay for... I don't know if it's cost more to license it for a heavier use or what. But anyways, there it is. I'm going to get those fenders welded on here. I don't know if you can see, I got all the boat stuff right there, and I got some more angle iron right there. I bought a bunch of angle iron to fix this up nice. So I'm going to come off the front here just to show you right quick. Okay, I'm going to come off. I'm going to cut that side over there, you know, at the angle, and scoot it up tight. And then I'm going to come all the way down here, cut that right there. I wish I had another hand. But yeah, this is going to get cut right here so that it'll fit right in there. So that from the side, it's just one nice, smooth, straight piece. Okay, so I'll have one like this. And then I'll have another one on the other side. Okay. So I'll have one coming from here, and then I'm just gonna sheet the whole top with just a big sheet of metal, just a big piece of sheet metal, and cut it to that shape, obviously, and then put a toolbox on it. And that'll cover all that mismatched looking stuff up. I think it'll look sweet. I'm gonna chop a bunch of this extra metal off too with the torch when I rent one. I don't have one yet. And it's got this weird jack on it, so I gotta take that off. And I bought a new crank for it from Harbor Freight. Yeah, get one of those. So yeah, I don't see why I wouldn't be able to get $1,500 for this thing. And with that work on it, and then painting it all black and making it look sweet, I don't see why I wouldn't be able to get more like $2,000 for it. Like if I was able to sit on this for a little while, I'd be asking $2,300 for it and try to settle around $2,000 just for the fact that it's a heavy machinery hauler. I mean, just because of the capacity. I would really have to get the axles checked out. I'd probably have to put new tires on it to get that price. I'd be painting the rims white. And it doesn't have any ramps. That's kind of a drawback. But I'd rather just for the $75 go to Harbor Freight and buy a set of ramps and just strap them on the deck, you know? I'd rather just sell it for $1,500, and there we go. So there's another thing, you know, that was $1,500. So I had a little skin on this one, but the trade still was a one-time trade, made me probably $1,000 at least. The boat made me, like I said, probably $1,000 to $1,500 with no money involved. So that was my two first trades, which went pretty good. Know if you guys remember the Aveyu. I never did a video on selling the Ford. No, that was not a Aveyu, that was a Chevy. Aspire. It was the Ford Aspire. So, there's a toy. So yeah, I need a toy. All right, so the Ford Aspire. I got the Aspire done. It was sitting out here in the front lawn forever. Had a few people, you know, comment about it and stuff. And then my brother, 6'2", 250 pounds. I don't know how much he weighs anymore, but he's a big guy. He drives a four-door Duramax with a 6-inch lift on it, you know, everything completely huge, and you know, just a gas hog. And I sent him pictures of it as a joke, you know, like, here's your next car, buddy. And he loved it. He freaking loved it. So he's like, I want it. So he came and checked it out, and he said, yep, I want it. I fixed the rust on it. I didn't get any pictures, I don't think, of me fixing the rust on it. There was some rust on the back tail, on the back gate, and when I went to paint it, it just, I got the paint color was wrong that we got, and then when I laid it down, it just went on terrible, bubbled everywhere. I don't know what the deal was with the paint, but it just went down terrible. I felt really bad, and I still want to fix that paint. So when I get him to come back up here to visit next, I will get some videos of what it looked like and then of me fixing it. But anyways, I traded my brother the Ford Aspire for 2000 Bombardier DS650. All right, so it was a pretty good trade. I mean, but if you think about it, he works, you know, 7 days a week. He has no time to use the four-wheeler, and he's got all the time in the world to drive to work and back in a car that's going to get him 10 times better gas mileage than his truck. Also, on a side note, everything he has to get for his truck cost him, you know, four times more than what it would buying a part for a car. You know, everything is just more expensive on a Duramax. I mean, it's going to cost, you know, it's like $200-$300 a tire just for tires, you know, that kind of thing. And this Aspire, we found tires brand new on TireRack.com for like $250 for a full set. But anyways, so that got done. I got a sweet quad that was worth, if I could have sat on it for a long time and did a couple little things to it, seat cover and stuff, it would have been worth $2,000. I mean, $2,100 all day, every day. But I ended up getting rid of it last month for $1,600. So basically pulled $1,600 out of the Aspire, which would have been almost undoable considering I would have only got about maybe $900 for the damn thing, you know? So that was cool. Got that done. Got the money out of that deal. So that was a sweet deal. Worked out for the best, you know, for both of us. So after that, I traded, I had that little TV up there. So I got some cool gas cans at the local swap meet the other day. Been going to swap meets now. The TV that was there, 22-inch piece of crap TV I never used, LCD, just old. I traded that and $50 for this quad. Okay, it's pretty sweet quad. It was terrible. Nothing worked on it. I was told the engine was locked up, and I figured maybe they didn't know what they were doing. Maybe just the pull rope was messed up, which it was. The motor wasn't locked up. The tranny was fried because I put it in gear and it would just roll down the driveway. Anyways, they came, dropped it off, and I was like, okay. But, I mean, still, if you think about it from a trading point of view, it's a quad. Like, someone could fix it somehow, put a new motor and tranny in it, whatever. It's still a frame with good shocks and stuff like that, you know. So I know I would be able to trade it for something worth, you know, $150 or so, $200 maybe, you know. So I ended up trading that. Oh, right after I got that, a jet ski came up on for trade, or came up on for sale. I also watched the for sales too, because you can buy stuff really cheap and trade it up to something worth a lot more. And I picked up an old 1991 Kawasaki TS650 jet ski. Just really retarded looking. Motor wasn't even hooked up. They had put some new stuff in it, but they never got it hooked up. The kids who bought it paid $400 for it. It was just a piece of crap. The hull was all tore up underneath. It needed fiberglass work. It was just a project, man. And it came on two-place motorcycle trailer. And they had put PVC pipes in there. If you can see in the picture, they put PVC pipe, big PVC pipe, in the tracks and used it as a jet ski trailer. So that's pretty cool. Actually, I still have that. I can show you that. So anyways, I got the ski and the four-wheeler. They looked like a match made in heaven. They looked exactly the same. Like, the jet ski looked like a jet ski version of my four-wheeler that I had. They looked terrible. Both of them looked terrible. So I took them to this one guy. I posted him up for trade. He was interested in both of them. He couldn't decide which one he wanted. He's like, I don't know. I'd rather have this one, or maybe I'd rather have this one. And my daughter's, my girlfriend's daughter's birthday came up, Alexa's, and she's just been really wanting an iPod Touch, and I didn't know anything about them, and started researching on them or whatever, and I guess the iPod Touch, the fourth generation, it looks just like an iPhone, but it's an iPod, and it's way thinner, and it doesn't have phone capabilities built into it anyway. You can always download an app for that, but anyways, they're worth like $300 for like the newest ones, the iPods fourth generation, they call them. They got cameras built in them now, I guess, is the big thing or whatever. So it's got a camera on the front, you know, so you can do Skype and, you know, FaceTime and stuff. So anyways, she wouldn't have cared. I could have got an old first generation one for $100 or $75 on Craigslist all day, but this guy was trading his iPod Touch fourth gen. So he said he'd take a couple $100 for it. I ended up trading the jet ski that I was into for $125. I tell you that, I spent $125 on the jet ski with the trailer. I traded him that, just the ski, not the trailer. I kept the trailer and traded him the jet ski, which to me was worth all of about maybe $50. To me, I mean, it's not worth, it was too much work to do anything with. It was scrap, basically. I could have pulled the motor out, maybe have tried to got it running and sold the motor, but, you know, it's just stupid. So I was able to trade that straight to the iPod for straight up. So that was a really sweet deal. I was able to get the iPod. We had to do a lot of running around and meeting with him to get it done, but we got it done. And in the same trade, I also traded him the four-wheeler. I brought the four-wheeler with, and he came up with some Traxxas gear. He's like, well, you know, I got some Traxxas stuff, and I'll trade you that, plus some fishing tackle, he said. So I'm like, okay, let's see it. So he brings out this Traxxas. If you guys know, these are the gas-powered, nitro-powered race cars, or RC cars, is what I meant to say. And, I don't really know a whole lot about them, except for this is the little bit older model 2.5 Traxxas motor, and it doesn't come, he didn't have a remote for it. So if this thing had the remote and it was in top gear and I had a fresh new body for it, like a new Silverado or something really cool, it'd be worth $300-$400 all day. As it sits right now, it's not worth that much. It's probably worth, I'm guessing, maybe $150 in parts. I mean, it really just needs a remote to work. So, I mean, they just had it working and stuff. So, it's got some nitro in it still in the gas tank. So, would love some more information on that. If you guys, I did some research and found out exactly what it is. It's the X, or what the hell is it? The T-Max? Yeah. It's an older T-Max with the 2.5 in it, I believe, if I'm saying that right. And, like I said, it needs a new body just to make it look sweet, because the bodies I've seen on eBay for these things are sick. Just sweet. I was thinking about painting it myself, but after I found the bodies online for like $25, I'm like, no way. Okay, so I traded him that crappy four-wheeler for that. And a tackle box just full of bass baits. I mean, I started adding this stuff up when he showed it to me. I'm just like, you know, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. You know? And then I opened it. And threw a bunch of stuff all over the place. And it just kept going, you know, another 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Because I know I've bought these before. Everything's $5, you know? Everything. So, guys. So, bunch of trend line, bobbers, just all kinds of shit in here. So, he wanted to trade me that and that for the quad. I'm like, cool, let's do it, you know? So, I'm guessing about, I mean, if I had to go buy all this stuff new, it'd be $250 worth of tackle, I know, just from looking through it already. I've looked through it really good. There's lots of spinner baits in here. You know, there's a couple of big-ass, musky baits in here. There's just huge slip bobbers and stuff, you know. So to buy all that stuff new would be, yeah, it'd be over $250. but I'm just throwing it out there. $150 worth of stuff. That's got to be worth $150. That's got to be worth $100 to $150. So I got $200 and $250, between $200 and $300 worth of stuff. You know, for the little crappy quad that I got. So that was that trade. It was a pretty good trade, and I just want to sell the stuff now. So that's that. Actually, I mean, I'm probably in the, I got my tackle box up there, but I don't have nearly as many bass. I mean, it's got some good bass baits in here. I might just clean it all up and give it to Rachel, because she fishes more than I do right now. And then the Traxxas, I mean, I can trade that easily. There's tons of that stuff on Craigslist for trade right now. All right, so where are we at here? Ski to iPad. Ski to iPod. Oh, yeah. The Traxxas and the tackle for the four-wheeler. Yep. All right, cool. So then the car for the quad was up there. Cool. So yeah, before I started all this, I didn't get any videos of it, but I did a Maxima. Or actually, I did. I get pictures and stuff. It was my first deal after I painted the Impala. I don't know if you guys seen that either. I two-toned an Impala, 2004 Impala cop car. And I also, right after that, I got this job off of that one. This is Jared's brother. I did the Impala for, and then this Maxima is their uncle, and he saw his car and wanted me to do his Maxima. It had some rust spots over the rear fenders and stuff, and it was a pearl paint. I sprayed a 3-stage pearl paint on a Nissan Maxima, so that was kind of a little bit intimidating, but it went really good. I actually welded metal in the fenders and stuff on that one too. The tractor that was sitting over there that I picked up for $40 from that garage sale, that was the last video I did. I got $300 for it at my garage sale. Winter's coming. I'm done mowing the grass. I didn't even use it to mow the grass. It just sat there the whole time. And because I needed a drive belt and a few little things, you know, battery and stuff, I just never got it going. And ended up selling it for $300. A guy offered me at a garage sale, so I'm like, you know what? I'll take it. Get it out of here. I'll buy another one next year. And I also made another $300 at the garage sale, so that was cool. And then did a fence job. I'll show you a picture and a short vid of the fence job here, so you guys can check out the fence job that I just got done doing.
Hey, Poochie. Hey, Poochie. Hey, Poochie, Poochie, Poochie. Okay. Okay. Jeez.
Jeremy here, Deciples Garage. As you can see, me and Nick, future real estate investors, are doing about the crappiest job anyone could ask to do on a nice, beautiful, hot, sunny day. So yeah, we did all of that, down almost that tree down there, and then all the way up to that white fence there, past the white fence. Pulled all these out, all the posts, pulled them out. Then we took a big stupid auger, reamed out the holes. Now we're setting them in cement. Yeah, Nick's got his line on there, making sure it's all staying nice and straight on top. Last panel sitting right here, ready to go on. It's not the right size, so we gotta make it bigger to fit that hole. Yeah, and we gotta top all those tops off flush. How's this experience changed your life, Nick?
Talk to the man upstairs.
Talk to him. Deal with. There's all the rock. They had to push the rock up away from the line there so that we could do this. And we've been battling it the whole time anyway because it keeps rolling down by our holes and stuff. And then there's the other, the neighbor's rock. So you got the neighbor's rock and this rock. It does not rock, that's for sure. It's gay. So yeah, and then those are all the, these are the vines that are all over the place. And of course there's one like in front of every post on this side. So yep. Never again. Not this guy. Oh yeah, got some rust.
Rust.
Yep. Chevy's starting to rust. I told him now'd be a good time to catch it. Yep. Gotta show these guys the rust.
Rust.
Yep, got a little spot going there. Yep. Mm-hmm. Gotta catch that stuff. Just telling them. It's a good looking truck. This is a 99. And it's in Minnesota. That's how good it looks. That's pretty crazy. How's this truck not rusted out right now?
That's an opportunity. Hey, is this your girlfriend?
Did you say that's
7229?
Enough?
7229? Yeah.
That's enough?
So that's, you know,
7-2. Do construction every once in a while. Like, still, I mean, this job just kind of came to me from one of my old contractor buddies that I used to do work for. He just called me up and said, hey, he's out of state now. He needs someone back here to help out his guy that was, you know, doing this whole fence job by himself. It was just a freaking, oh my, just a job, man. Just freaking grueling ass work. You know, I'd rather do a roof. I mean, this started off as, you know, showing you guys, you know, an idiot, you know, trying to do body work and starting off with no knowledge whatsoever and then learning everything on YouTube about how to do body work and working his way up, you know. So that's, you know, that's what people have been wanting to see on the channel, and they've been waiting for me to flip some more vehicles and stuff. And, you know, I probably will in the future be doing more. But right now I just got my eyes set on a bigger goal. You know, using the mindset of flipping, it all really applies exactly the same to houses. There's just a little more paperwork involved and a little more work. There's a lot more work involved, especially when you're getting started off and you don't have any good connections with investors and stuff like that. So. That's where I'm at right now. The past week, my stomach's been in knots because I'm putting offers on 3 houses right now, with no money down and with no money in my pocket. And if you guys are interested in that, kind of comment below. Just say, hey, what's up? You know, it's good to hear from you guys. I haven't heard from anybody in a long time. So, I mean, just tell me how's it going on your end and stuff. And if that's something that you guys think would be interesting, I'm just going to kind of put it out there. I mean, the information is completely invaluable, and it's just running through my head every day. It was just like when I learned bodywork. It was like, oh my gosh, hey, I cut the metal out, and you just weld the new pack panel in. You got to be really careful when you melt. You know, I was just thinking about that stuff all night long, you know, putting a skim coat on there just like Pisser does, you know, and do it like that, you know, and then do the paint and paint, you know, like, you know, VW Darren, like he does, and I fucking watch the paint, you know, and stuff like that. So that's really cool, you know, and then, you know, eventually I like to do like cool, like, you know, metallics and like, you know, stuff, you know, Wild Island Northern Boy, you know, doing that stuff like that, you know, and be like commercial break and all that kind of stuff, you know, and then being like, you know, that'd be cool, and then I could do impressions of everybody, you know, like VW Darren, you know, doing impressions of VW Darren, and like I could do an impression of Pisser and Wild Island Northern Boy, and that'd be funny if I did an impression of Wild Island Northern Boy. He'd be so pissed off, but everybody would be like, oh my god, that was funny, you know, and put comments on there all the time. I was all into it just like that. That's how I'm into it right now with the real estate thing. So stay tuned, because I'm going to make it happen. I'm going to make stuff happen. I'm going to get it on video. I don't know what channel. I guess I'll throw it up on the Deciples Corner channel. I mean, because it's going to be my... It's basically my journey that I'm supposed to be taking, that I know God's led me to do. So like I said, if you guys are interested in that stuff, leave your comments below and just kind of let me know, hey, yeah, cool, man, that'd be cool to see that, or you know, we don't give a you know, we don't care about that stuff, you know, whatever, you know, just let me know. So yeah, this is Jeremy, Deciples Garage, Deciples Corner, wishing blessings upon all you people out there that watch these videos, and I'll try to stay in touch and not be so much of a stranger. All right, thanks everybody. God bless.